Alright, so I just took some pictures over there by that tree. There was some nice light from the lamp. Now I'm gonna keep walking this way. Once again, I'm just shooting some Portra 400, pushing it one stop to 800. I did this with some Ultramax, some Kodak Ultramax, and I pushed it in camera and then I pushed it in development and it came out really cool. But I also know that Kodak Ultramax doesn't have as great of a exposure latitude as Portra. So I wanted to try the same thing using some Portra because I know hopefully the grain will be a little bit more fine and be a bit nicer. So I might take a pic right here. This tree. With each photo that I'm taking, I'm kind of taking two because I'm going either off of the light meter on my camera or the light meter on my phone. But often I can see that the camera and the phone give me two different readings. Hopefully my phone is doing okay because I think the readings off that are pretty accurate, but once again, I'm still learning, so.
When you're taking a photo where you're not really sure about the exposure, it's really helpful if you bracket your images, which is what I'm doing here. It's where you basically take the same image a couple of different times with different exposures to just see which one works the best. And from there, you can learn in the process of looking at the images again and trying to learn what the settings mean and how they impact your photo. In the moment, it may seem like you're wasting them, and definitely when I was doing this, I felt like I was just wasting frames, but in the end, I'm really glad I did because obviously some of the photos came out really bad and some came out pretty good. So sometimes it's really important to do that, especially when you're just learning a new technique or maybe you're doing something you've never done before.
All right, I'm gonna take a pic here of this car under that light. Shutter release cable has fallen out of my camera so many times during this night, and usually it's fine. And it's a $5 one I got from B&H. I got a cheap one. Official review, it is fine until it doesn't work. I see a black cat walking across the street. I don't know if you can see it. Cat had kept walking. I would have taken a picture of its silhouette in the light. That was pretty cool. I'm so sweaty. I'm wearing, I'm wearing track pants and a little windbreaker because it's, you know, nighttime and it's Florida. There's cicadas and bugs and mosquitoes and I don't want to get bit. Because I remember one of the first times I went out to take some photos at night, a cicada landed on my face and that was pretty traumatizing, so. Hicks while the, So I just finished the roll, and the last like four photos that I took, I didn't use the shutter release cable because I was just lazy, and it was on a tripod and I was hopefully pretty careful with it. But I'm like glad that I'm done because I'm really sweaty and I'm honestly getting really tired.
Anyway, at this point I was walking home and I was really tired, rambling about nothing. You can literally see me hobbling here because my foot was cramping. And if you listen to this next clip, you can hear my foot dragging.
Instead, because there's some great photos over here as well that...
But anyway, I think it's safe to say we'll end the video here so you don't have to watch me hobbling anymore. But besides that, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you want to check out more of my work, you can check out my photos on my Instagram and my website for my full portfolio. You can also check my TikTok for more videos about film and photography, and my Twitter to keep up with whatever is going on. But besides that, that's all for now. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time. All right, bye.